this is what happens when you buy a southern cab, but you don't really check it that good. Point out all the rot. We can rebuild it, but it would cost a fortune in steel. Because it's just everything, all this crispy, everything crispy. The front section is the only thing that's really decent, except for where the body mounts are all rotted out. The back section's totally crushed.
Back at you live, VTSB Auto. This is a big day for us. We're doing the frame measurements for Mr. Lofton's 72 Impala to get the process continued with building the chassis. I always wanted to build a chassis for a car. A lot of the guys that I look up to that build cars, Ken Diggett, Chip Foose, Boyd Connaughton, those type of builders, they're gonna start with a brand new chassis. You don't have to have a rusted out frame with those guys I mentioned to go get a new chassis. They're going to get a new chassis because of the benefits of the new suspension. Like I said, the rack and pinion, as well as the coilover suspension that gives you a lot better feel and control, the modern feel like a new car would have. Just like in the rear of the car, the rear end is gonna be a lot better. All of the components to deal with your rear end, the suspension, the trailer, and everything is going to be a lot better on a more modern car. That's the benefit where a true car builder would start with a chassis. Well, this one is also rotted out. So I believe Mr. Rich was going over these body mount locations. If you just look at the circumference of this circle, this is the true diameter where the body mount is supposed to fit. It's probably about an inch and a half diameter there. Well, if you could look, now it's done rotted out to close to 3 inches. Well, obviously that's not factory. If you look at the opening to get access to the bushing, it's bigger, it's rotted bigger than that one, the one on the bottom, if you see this, you know. So this is a problem. Now, by the time you strip all of this to the metal to try to correct it and fix this frame, can we do it? Absolutely. The problem is my job is not only to help collect your money, it's my job to help spend your money the wisest way. You're gonna spend, you know, with the number of hours that you're gonna have repairing this frame, you can have, you know, $7,000 to $10,000 trying to correct this frame. Why not just buy a brand new one? You know, even if this frame was in good shape and you wanted to do the suspension on it, let's just say we wanna do all of the bushings. When you have these cars, you gotta do the bushings on them, in and out of tie rod, upper and lower ball joints, the center link, all of those bushings over time get worn out, you gotta replace them. You can have $2,000 just in that. Why do that if my frame is rotted and then I still put all that together and get you a new frame, which is what we're starting here today. So we're just gonna start collecting measurements based off of what the dimensions. I'm gonna get on the phone with Scotty's, who is the company that's making it. Just because this is the first time we're doing this, Mr. Rich can do this in his sleep, but I want to just double check, triple check 100 times just to make sure, you know, because it's going to be a 6-month wait before we get it, and then we definitely don't want to get it in 6 months, and then we have to do it more work to the chassis than that should have already been done.
You can basically see where close to dead center is. Being off a quarter of an inch is nothing. The body mounts are that from the factory. So that's why we're gonna do the body after we do this and jot down both measurements. That way we have the actual where the center of the bolt goes done.
By his damn self. Jim Days, body by
me. If I have to wait for people, I have to wait for people.
Yeah, what he said.
You ain't do it by yourself. It ain't get done sometimes.
And don't forget it. What kind of shirt we going to get? What we say we going to sell the shirt?
Get done or get to work.
Right.
Get to work. That's it.
Measure twice, cut once. So these are pretty much the body mounts on the car itself. stove, we got the measurements we believe that they totally need for the frame. I'm gonna get back on the phone with them, send it over to them, and get the rocket. I'm waiting. I'm just waiting for them to give me a shout back, just to make sure there's nothing that we overlooked. Is there any of the measurements they may need? And then we'll go from there. Shout out, man. We build cars from the ground up the right way. We might not be your cheapest, but we one of the baddest around. VTSB Auto, man. Let's go.